Hi, welcome to Closure Script Game, episode 11. Today I thought we will do a little bit of refactoring and split code into modules because our code base is quite big. It's getting bigger and bigger, so it's time we start managing that code. But also, we'll probably do some optimization on how resizing works. Okay, so we have main here, right? So the parts that we have here, it's model, right? That database and schema. Then we have initial state. Then we have renderer here. And we have animation here. So I thought we'll do model first, then renderer, then animation, something like that. Let me start with creating a namespace for that. It will be called model. And we probably won't need this. String, I don't know, maybe we'll need string, I don't know. I need to save this. Oops. This is not right. What we move there is schema. We don't move initial state because it's initial state is actually part of the initialization, not the model itself. We will move the database there, so like this, and we will move entities there. One event is not part of the model as well. Okay, so and here we don't have that, and because we the database here will be just an empty DB. It's a connection with the schema. So I can simplify it like that. And this is an utility function, so it goes, I don't know, somewhere on top probably. Yes, this one are private because probably nobody is interested in them. Anyways, schema is okay to be public, I guess. And here we will have to add here's model. As model, I also usually I don't do use refer, but because dim and pos are so crucial to everything we'll be using positions and dimensions, so that I'll make an exception and refer them here. Okay, then let's see. So this will work, entities will not work. Have three of them, we have to do that. Then our initialization. So initialization here, we will just reset our database with a new database value, which will be, let me think, so it will be data script DB with data script empty DB with model schema. And yeah, okay, probably it's easier if you write it like this. So it's empty DB with initial tags, right? So each time we reload, we just reset its state, okay? And then we mount the application again. Maybe it's not a good idea really that we should do that on load, but while we're developing, I think it's fine. I think it's fine for now at least to reset the whole state, okay? Because we'll be adding something and stuff like that. Okay, so let's see if it works. Let's see if it compiles. No, it does. Oh, we are now DB is actually escaped, right? So DB here is gonna be model. Then here it's an argument, it's fine. Here it's gonna be model again. And here it's gonna be model. Okay, so now it should be fine. Yes? Yes. Nice. Yeah, it seems to work. Okay, great. Actually, I'm thinking that maybe I will do that on the second thought. And we actually have it's fine. Yeah, reset is fine. So reset is fine. So once the application loads, we reset the database. After that, we don't touch it. So for example, if code changes, animations will stay in the place. and everything like selection and all the dynamic states that we accumulated while interacting with the app will stay in its place. If we change the schema or if we add a new unit on a few battlefield or something like that, we will have to reload, and that will be our signal to recreate the database. So maybe it's time to do that because we will start to get interactivity in here pretty soon. Okay, so next thing that I'm going to do is probably animation. Let's create an animation. Yes, like this. I did remove, I always forget about this animation. We probably need, why does it keep appending CLJ suffix? It's strange. And animation is everything that we have. One event is rendering more or less. Animation is this. Okay, so it's pre-collocated. And yes, these are utility functions which I'm, for now, I just use them here, but maybe soon we'll have to create like utility namespace or something like that. Animate mixin, yes, so post dim. What are we? Well, we probably won't use Google DOM. We are not using RAM in animation, which is fine because it only interacts with a database. It doesn't render anything, which is like a signal that our separation of systems and data works, which is great. Yeah, I also tend to sort namespaces from shortest to longest. I probably should get off this Guido and replace it with JS document get element by ID. Then we have this, probably because we already in animation namespace, we could use just that. So it's just a mixin, right? And that should be enough. No, it's not enough. What was there? No, it's fine right now, right? Let's reload and see if the state. Yeah, everything works as before. Great. So it means we moved animation correctly. And the last part is render, right? So let's move render here. Yeah, let me just go. No, let me go here and that wheel hooks will stay in main. Probably won't need animation here. Data script maybe, model certainly. So it's gonna be render CLJS. Okay, I don't understand why it's using doing that, but yeah, probably my Sublime is behaving that way for some reason. Need that comment in here. Okay, so we need on event, we need sprite, screen, Windows dimension, scale, and app, right? So app is tricky. I'm not yet sure. Yeah, it probably should go to render as well. So let me just move everything here. Yes. Let's see what doesn't work for that. So okay, so we have to import animation in here. Yes. What else? It's fine. And render is probably going here. Render up. And now, yeah, on reload. Okay, this is fine. So main is basically just hooks and interaction with big wheel and initial state for database, which is also a good place for it, I think. Yep, it still works. Great. So yeah, and here we probably, again, this is maybe is going to utility namespace because it's like generic. For now, just, yeah, no, because it's utility. So yeah, there are components, there's Windows dimension, Screen scale up. So I told you that I want to do one optimization. So if you notice, we are doing some calculations directly in the render method, right? So in RAM component, everything that goes after in the body of DFC is a render method. So each render, we actually recalculate the scale of the window by querying the window DOM, and we calculate the scale, which, well, calculation is fast probably, right? But interaction with window JS DOM might be slow. And anyways, it's unnecessary work, especially because we, for example, re-render each time we change the animation. So each time we animate any of this, you will have a re-render and recalculation. So what I want to do is instead use a local state in this component to keep the scale and width and high, and just load them from scale, and use a mixin that will just update them when resize happens or when component first is going to mount. So yeah. Anyway, let me just show you, and it might be a good example also how to use local state in RAM. So to do that, we use RAM local. Well, initial state is, well, okay, it's nil. The value might be nil. We are going to use, well, we are going to use scale. We're going to use window dim, right? So because we are using this structure, that's better to use probably here. So initial values for those are nil, right? And we are going to actually do this. What are we going to do? Yeah, so on event probably we'll have to change a little bit. Now let me write a mix in right here. We'll mount, and then we'll figure out where is the proper place to put it. So get state, right? We destructure it to get following keys, scale, window, dim. Do you see that? Windom, yes, this is wrong. Window dim. Alright, so we get those from state. These are actually like a real keys on state. And the only trick is they're immutable, they're atoms, right? So if we actually, let me do that instead. So we scale. We will destructure them as datums. Okay, so scale. Maybe I should use a single value for them, but whatever. Yes. So this is our state. Now, before the component mounts, we actually have to provide the values for it. Okay, let me do that instead. Okay, so I'm going to write a function that calculates the scale. Oh, if we have that. Let me call it. Oh, scale. Are we using scale anywhere else? No. Okay, so scale and window dim. And I'm just using that because I need it as well. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. So window dim is this, right? So, well, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to do that. Oh, I also have rotate somewhere. Okay. Oh, I'm already using meta for that. Actually, I'm thinking that maybe I shouldn't be using meta here. Okay, so I'm going to write a single function that will be scale. I'm also going to do... let me have res. Res is... So the trick I'm using here is that in our model, dim and pause are actual records, right? And you can put additional values on records, just like maps, and they will keep being records, basically. Okay, so this is what our result will have keys, width and height. A key, optionally, it might have a key rotate, and it also will have a key scale. Okay, so we have to. No, it's fine. Okay, let's call it dim. Okay, then we'll have step is 0.5. This is correct. Then we need the scale. So scale is gonna be this loop. Here we are going to do that. Okay. So now we have scale dim. Oh, we can have rotate key is here. Okay, it doesn't matter. Oh, yeah, here we can. We can do that for now. And what we're going to return here is a sock dim with rotate. Yes, and scale. This is what we are going to return from scale. This one we don't need because it's already encapsulated here. So basically, we are returning a structure with four keys: width, height, rotate, and scale. You can actually return a map, not a record, but it doesn't really matter. Okay, so we have it here. Let's call it window dim. Let's call it window dim as well. So alternatively, we could have used meta, but it doesn't matter. Okay, let's call it window dim, and here we are going to reset key in state. No, okay. yes, we are going to reset this key in state with window dim, okay, and return the original state. This is what we are going to do in here. Actually, yeah, so we should do that in when calculating the initial value. I'm not sure if I can. I probably can, right? Why not? We can. Okay, so this is our initial value, and here we are going to do window dim is. So we have to change this to DFC, then there's going to be state, and we have to dereference it. So this is our window dim. The scale is. Well, the scale is on 8, so here we could just use scale on dim. I probably just call it dim for short. If rotate dim, and here as well scale dim, right? Oh, I also have to recalculate those, so I probably should do this instead. Okay, let me just do. So I'm going to create a new dim here with this match width. And this much height. And I'm going to assort to that dim. Rotating scale. So all this we don't have to recalculate, right? We don't need the real dimension of the window. We need just scale dimension, like that. Okay, so right now it should work. If I wrote this everything correctly, it should work, but it won't resize if I did everything correctly. Let's see. No, it didn't work. It didn't even work. Okay, let's see what it didn't even mount. What? Does it work differently? Let's see. So dim call is not a function. No. What? Yeah, because I already have dim here. Okay. Yeah, I'll have to use the fullest codified name. Okay, so there was an exception and nothing started to work. Okay, yeah, as I expected, it renders, but it doesn't react to the resize, which is good, because it means that on each render we are not recalculating this. So this is good, right? So now we have to figure out how to react on resize. And this is actually pretty fine. Callback, event listener, state. Yeah, no, this is easy actually. So we have a callback. And we're getting component. We should be getting state, I think, instead. Right. A component. No, probably component. Let me look up if I have a function in RAM to get state from component, because I might. There is quite a lot of utility functions. Cursors, React, Reactive, Local, Static. So we have reference, we have DOM node, we have Resref, this key, we don't have. Oh, given React component, return RAM status traded. Yeah, this is the one that we need. Great, so this is great, actually. So in this event, let me just do what I think should be done. RAM state comp. And we are going to reset window dim in that with window dim. Yes. Let's see. Let's see. So nothing changes so far. And it didn't work. Okay, great. Okay, but let me explain you the idea. So on event, is a mixin that we wrote ourselves, but it's fine. Right, so each time it mounts, it registers on event callback. And to that callback, it will be passing React component, not the RAM component. Well, there is no such thing as RAM component. And not the state, so it could have passed state, but the trick is that state here is immutable. So it will just, when creating this closure, it will just closure over it, and that's not what we need. We actually need an actual like component state. Oh, I probably know why, because state is mutable, but it does concerns me a little bit. Yeah, I have to change it to that. And this should work. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, great, it works. Okay, so again, let me continue explaining. So when I'm calling this, I'm closing over React component, which doesn't change, right? So React component stays the same, but as long as it exists, but it will exist because we're using it as a mixin, right? If React components disappears, so the whole thing with the mixin itself disappears. So we are passing React component, but now we need to get the current value of the state, the RAM state, from it. So we have a function for that in RAM, which is RAM state, but it returns a mutable reference, but which is fine. So we take that mutable reference, dereference it, we get the state, which is the normal state, right? So this will be, let's say like this. Maybe it will be easier to read this way. Okay, so we get the component, we get the state from it, which is like current state of the state, right? So in that state, we look up the, our local value, like this, this local value. Let me put it before. So they normally, yeah, I prefer them to come in order, or it doesn't really, well, it matters a little. It doesn't matter here specifically, but I prefer them to be ordered in logical independency order, right? So first we need something like local atom in a state to remember this dimension. And then we need to react on resize, right? So here, yeah, we get the state, we find a reactive reference like this reference in here, and we reset its value. Then RAM local, it works this way. When you reset the value or update the value, doesn't matter, that holds, it will cause a re-render. So yeah, it will just cause a render. So we don't need to explicitly ask for it, right? Then in this state we find this this value, and it's fine, right? So yeah, it's probably not a good idea to call it dim though, because it conflicts with this dim, and I probably have change just to be safe in the future. And probably here as well. As much as I like the short name, I'll have to be careful. It's just so that next time I don't spend this extra minute figuring out why dim call doesn't work. Okay, so it's usually not a good idea to override function names with local variables. And it's a little bit of shame, because when you need a name and Clojure actually have function called name, so you usually shouldn't use a local variable called name. But anyways, yeah, so I guess this is it for now. So we did the refactoring, we split our code into a couple of modules, right? So we didn't introduce the utility one, but it's fine. I think, or maybe we should, I don't know, really. Maybe the position and dim should go into core. Oh, okay, yeah, so this is a good idea, actually. Let's call it core. I like this. So let's call it heroes.core and move from, yes, it's core CLJS, come on. Where did it save it? Where is it? It should be, oh yeah, it's here. Oh. Okay, yeah, it uses correct namespace actually. Oh, if you copy paste Clojure code into empty file, yeah, it changes it syntax. Wow. Okay, yeah, this is interesting. So the Sublime remembers from which file you copied it and moves your syntax here. So this one's go here. Okay. And we probably here score refer dim pass. Yes. As core. Yeah. So you might want to use it. Okay. So this is going to be everywhere. So let me just start doing this. Recorder. Okay, so on event, I could have actually changed that so that. Yeah. Okay, let's change the on event mixin so that it actually passes the state and accepts the state. So this then it should work like this. it will be update on RAM state. It's gonna be vswap on RAM state comp. So this is important. We should do this inside the closure, so we want the closure on over it. And we are calling the callback. So now we are going to, we expect that callback will accept state as a value, not a, and return state as a value, right? And it could do whatever it wants with it. And we only use it here, so the only place we have to change is here. And we, what we do, we use that as an opportunity to just change this and nothing else, okay? So we basically just return the same invalid referrer. Okay, yeah, so we have to move it here as well and remove this part. And move it in here. Okay. Yes? Yes, it seemed to work. Great. And oh no, it doesn't work. So I probably forgot something. So let me just see. I reset defined for missing protocol, reset main what. So now it misses something. What? DB. So probably model didn't work. Huh. Yeah. Oh, because I'm using those and it doesn't know where those come from. Okay, here's core. Let me just reference them here. Yeah, great. So now it kind of works. At least we get the background, but we don't get them, the units for some reason. So it's probably, there's probably another error. Oh, no, we get everything. Okay, great. Okay, we got everything, so everything works, and we moved those to core. I also just want to move everything that looks like kind of useful anywhere to the core, like those basically utility methods, right? So this makes sense, it's animation specific. Less, let me core less than this one and this one. Okay, and render, maybe we should move on event there. It's not, it's RAM specific, but yeah, it's fine. Require RAM core as RAM, we depend on RAM anyways. And on event is gonna be, it's gonna be core. Okay. Yes. Yes, everything works. I hope so. I probably missed one. Yeah, I missed one. It's plus. And actually one Z. Now it works. And now everything works. Great. So yeah, now we have our utility namespace sort of. So it's namespace that everyone could actually rely on. Maybe you should move a model there. I don't know. Oh no, model is fine in model, I guess. And this is it, I think. So yeah, a little bit of refactoring, a little bit of optimization, and also you may have noticed that I drew a new unit, a zombie. So yeah, it's here as well. So thanks for watching, and stay tuned for next episodes. Bye bye.